My name is Matthew Peters, and I'm from Seattle, Washington, currently living in Puerto Rico. And this was my second retreat here at Namayakaya Healing Center. It's been a very beautiful process working with like-minded people who are ready to look at themselves. The space itself is so lush, so relaxing. It took me about a day to just unwind and like be free of my cell phone, be free of the day-to-day busyness of the mind. As you walk around, when you first arrive here, you just see all these plants, you hear the jungle, and it's unlike anything in the city that I or anyone else I imagine has ever experienced. So that's the backdrop. Like that's just the first, like when you arrive, wow, I'm arriving somewhere very, really special. As far as the ceremonies go, they are very powerful. And I find like you really have to be just willing to be in your heart space, be willing to look at yourself. And it can be really hard. I had some ceremonies where I just wanted to tap out. I don't want to keep going. And then like this little voice would come back in and say, this is why we're here. We need to look at ourselves. There seemed to be this gradual moving towards something by, I'd say, the third ceremony, and it became very evident by the fourth ceremony. And in the first ceremony, what came up is there's specific friendships that I hadn't really been communicating well in, and I get to go back and make space to have more authentic conversations and try to repair some friendships that I feel like I've put off to the side. And in the second ceremony, ayahuasca helped me connect with one of my intentions, which was to process emotions. I tend to walk around in life really disassociative, really disassociated from my body, living in my head and planning for the future. And I just found over the last so many years this anger and resentment that I couldn't name. I couldn't really put a narrative to, and I'd find myself projecting that anger out into my relationships or beating myself up because I didn't understand how to process. And she just helped me get perspective. It wasn't like she brought a narrative forth to say like, oh, this is the origins of your anger, this is the origins of all your resentment. She just helped me see that all emotions are just that, emotions. They don't have to be seen as negative or held down and repressed. And it was a very, very freeing experience to yell, to laugh, to make noises that I would typically filter myself from, even by myself. So it became very apparent how much I was trying to control in my everyday life the creative expressions, the like just the raw expression of being human. And she helped me understand that I have control of giving myself that permission. I have the power. And I think that's one of the most powerful things about this work is it's so self-empowering. And with that, knowing that when I go back to my daily life, my day-to-day, that the work is still there to do, and I'm equally excited and nervous because of course there's the questions of will I be able to hold the changes that feel like are in my life now, the changes of ownership, so ownership and not abdicating my power in day-to-day life. Yeah, she's a powerful medicine. I also found myself in the first three ceremonies, actually all four ceremonies, like there's a good, I'd say, hour of where you're waiting, you're sitting with the medicine. And for me, the narrative always comes up from like, maybe my work is done with this medicine. Maybe we've gone as far as we can go. And it's been a very beautiful journey. I remember saying that. And then like clockwork, the medicine would kick in and there's lessons to be learned and stuff to look at. By the fourth ceremony of that song and dance, of the like, maybe we're done, maybe I didn't take enough, maybe this, maybe that. she just brought it all. It's like she brought ceremony 1, 2, and 3 to a head. She brought it all together and was showing me how it was building towards being able to surrender, being able to really look at myself, really look at what self-empowerment means. So this medicine is really for anyone who is searching for meaning, searching for answers. This medicine's for anyone who's consciously curious. And what I mean by consciously curious, I mean that they are approaching this opportunity not as an escape, not as a party. The language of medicine is accurate. It's ayahuasca works on the body, the mind, your emotional level, the spirit. She is dynamic and she is consensual. She will never take you at a pace that you cannot handle. And I recall in one ceremony tapping out where I was brought into a regression of being a child, and some abuse and trauma was being shown to me, and it was so painful, and I just did not want to look. And I remember saying, it's too much, I can't. And in that moment I purged. I didn't realize it, but I was crying. And it was only after ceremony, in retrospect, that the dots connected, that she will always respect your limits, your boundaries. And there are other moments where you think you're at your boundaries, at your limits, and you come to find out you're much stronger than you give yourself credit for. So if you're wondering, am I ready for this medicine? Or is this medicine for me? She is for you. She is for your well-being. She is for your evolution and development. Whether you're ready to show up, that's on you. It's always on us. But I hope you'll take the invitation. It's been a beautiful journey, and it continues to be.